worried are you about the terrorists? What can Europe actually do?
We are worried. We see no winners in the trade war. Long term, everybody will lose. So we hope that Mr. Trump will withdraw this idea.
Do you think it will de-escalate? What can Europe do to defend themselves? Does Europe need to retaliate or play it cool?
So if the US government confirms the measures, then Europeans will have to discuss about countermeasures. And the European Commission already has proposed some very concrete steps, and we are ready to discuss them.
Madame Deputy Minister, when you look at the European Central Bank, when you look at the Italian elections, where do you see the main concern for France?
I think the main concern for France at the moment is the trade war issue. So we are going to address it with our partners in Europe.
What role can France play in all of this? Do the Italian elections in some way, and also the upheaval that we saw in Germany, taking so long to find a government, make France one of the strongest countries in the European Union?
I think France is ready to play a large role in what we need to do in Europe to make Europe stronger, to provide some answers to citizens in Europe. As you saw in Italy, we need to be more efficient in when we tackle a migration crisis, for example. We also need in the Eurozone to build something stronger. So France has ideas, has very concrete proposals, and is ready to play this role.
I mean, the Macron effect is actually being felt. We also heard from JP Morgan and the chief executive that, you know, he brought a new energy to Europe. When you look at some of the reforms, including the reform on labor, when do you expect it to actually see it tangibly in the figures?
Yes, you're right. President and the whole government is very energized and has a very strong program. It's a comprehensive transformation program. So we started with labor market reform, with an overhaul of the taxation system. We will continue to work on business environment, on training. So it's really addressing deeply the weaknesses of the French economy. So it will take some time to deliver very durable results, but we are, you know, ready to continue to work and to address everything that is important.
The French finance minister was, Monsieur Bruno Le Maire was in London a couple of days ago, saying that actually when it comes to Brexit and when it comes to negotiating, there won't be a special place for financial services. What does that mean for France? Can you attract jobs away from London to Paris?
Paris has huge assets, very extraordinary assets and advantages to offer to financial businesses. So I think in terms of taxation, we have improved our situation. In terms of expatriate package, we have a very, very good package. We have the quality of life in Paris. We have all the skills and business schools around. So I think Paris can have a good position in terms of financial services in the future.
How much does the finance ministry spend time on Brexit, and how much do you only focus on, you know, domestic policies?
We focus on both, and also on European issues. I think it's important to as I told you, we have a very full program of reforms for France. So we, of course, have a deep agenda on this. But Brexit and Europe are a strong subject we also need to work on.
You're a businesswoman that is now into the finance ministry and politics. This is also International Women's Day. Do you think there will be more movement to try and get women in the workplace to stay, to basically go beyond, you know, the glass ceiling to become chief executives?
Yes, sure. This morning we were the whole government, the whole French government, working on the women's rights issues. So on every field we have a full agenda. You know that Mr. Macron had this topic in his program even before the Me Too movement. So, you know, we have been preparing for months to have a strong action. And in terms of companies and what's happening in companies, we want to tackle the pay gap between men and women with very concrete solutions like transparency and you know, having all companies to tackle this, also to help women create companies. Mm-hmm. So this is obviously part of the topics we want to move on.
Does that have to come from the private sector or from wanting to within, or is it government that actually has to impose it on the private sector, on private companies?
The government will push for things to be addressed, because otherwise it's not moving fast enough.
Is it tough being a businesswoman in France?
It's I don't think it's tough, but it's something that needs to be encouraged, because ambitions stay, you know, are more restricted with women than men. So we need to help women speak up and live up to their ambitions.
A final question: how difficult or how much assets does a businesswoman have bringing politics? Are you different from other politicians? How do you run your office?
I try to be very direct, so probably more informal than a politician, and also to hear from everybody and to be very open to what's coming from the private sector and as well as my own services in the ministry. But I think it's a balance, and it's a good spirit to work in this direction.